Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. This should be the final part for the subterranean complex. Unless I need to go back in here and get some purples or something like that for a future area. But looks like we got another bomb rock centric floor here, and oh god, Gatling groinks. These things are such a difficult enemy, and that one's in like a sniper position and everything. Those things, what they do is they shoot out balls of explosions, I guess you could say, and it'll stun Pikmin and knock them around, but if Pikmin are caught in the direct center of the explosion, it'll actually kill them off. And because they have such a wide range and they can shoot so many bullets at once, they are an incredibly dangerous enemy. So I wouldn't really feel all that bad if I lost even purples to them because of how difficult they are. But we'll see how many losses I get on them overall, I suppose. And there's one over here, it's walking. It's not in the sniper position the other one was. And I'm just activating these bomb rocks here because they suck. Oh, and by the way, I'm pretty sure Gatling Groinks are immune to... Oh, they're not immune to bomb rocks. Maybe I should have led him around. just to see if I could get his HP down. But I should probably take my Pikmin squad over here really quickly now that I got all the bomb rocks cleared out, because they actually, if I'm not mistaken, recover their HP. Yeah, that makes them even more dangerous. So let's hurry this along here. And by the way, they also have a shield on their front, so you just can't throw Pikmin on top of them and expect that you're going to be able to do damage to them. So, oh god. Okay, now, you'll notice it's going to start recovering, believe it or not, when it dies. See that its HP is going back up? So take it back to the base. No matter what, you want to get it back to the base, because if you don't, it's going to come back to life, you're going to have to deal with it all over again, and you will not be happy with that, especially if it becomes alive back where your Pikmin squad is and whatnot. Okay, so it's back to the base, it's done, so it's cleared out, and uh-oh, I thought that was it! Okay, we're good? Okay, we're good. Just as long as you call your Pikmin back and you don't get too stuck on things, you should be perfectly fine being able to call them back quick enough when a volatile deal falls from the ceiling and whatnot. So, yeah. Alright, so things are going relatively well. Kind of well, sort of well. Makes me wonder if I shouldn't have been so casual about not taking that many yellows in this place, because I gotta deal with that Gatling Groink at a higher spot. And that could be an issue, unless there's a way for me to trade colors in on this floor, like trade blues for yellows or something, but I don't think there is. Oh, there's more bomb rocks over here, so I should probably knock those for a loop. Well, I could throw Pikmin up. Yeah, I probably could throw Pikmin up from right there, right next to him, but I gotta do it carefully. Treetop something. Thirst activator. How should I deal with you? Probably need all the purples I can get. Because purples have that stunning effect sometimes, and they have high attack power. So let's take a small squad in here, and... Oh, it's turned away! Good. Oh, shoot, it's bouncing off the wall, just like the time I lost yellows in that dumb throw. Okay, we're good. It's stuck on something. I will use this to my advantage. Yes. No. Shoot, it's turning around now. Okay, now we're gonna have to deal with it in full force. Oh yeah, stun, sweet. Okay, kill it, because it's got something good. Okay, that wasn't that bad. That could have gone a lot worse. Okay, no volatile devils, please. Very much appreciate that. And you are getting carried back to the base. Maybe I won't have to. Yeah, I can't get Pikmin up on that. Dang it. Okay, so I'm gonna have to leave it, I guess. Well, it's gonna be stuck up there anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. You know, it's not gonna wander around the area and attack Pikmin, so it's not really that worrisome since I already took care of it. I got the treasure from it. And there we go. Good. Yeah, let's get a couple more colors on here. Go. Did I hear Pikmin screaming? I thought I heard Pikmin screaming. Hmm. He was my imagination. Alright, another one of these things. Indomitable CPU! Okay, how much more do we have to find this place? How much more? Well, let's see here. Oh, very nice. Threw it over there, which means that it should be perfectly safe to attack now. I should say it fell over there, because sometimes those bombs just fall in the most inopportune places when you're battling them, and it's just total disaster. Okay, good. Probably need some... Oh wait, there's another roll of tape here. Is something gonna fall from the ceiling, right? Something's gonna... Yep, I thought so. Never trust a dead end with a treasure. And there we go. Alright. Grab it, and go. Good. Go, 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 go. that Gatling Grunk on the other side is probably recovered by now. But, eh, I don't think I have to go through there anyway. As you've seen, I checked for treasure along that side. Oh no, it hasn't recovered just yet, but it's almost very, very close. Different brand of tape this time, not gamma. Oh ho ho. Furious adhesive. Okay, the treasure is cleared out of this place. So let's get out of here before we lose Pikmin to the doom that is this floor. But where is the exit to this? Where? What? Oh, all the way on that side. Okay, I'm just gonna leave my squad there. And run for it! Yes! Even across the hatches. Oh, I hear the Gatling Grunk has recovered. I hear it going... Wark, 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 wark. And, but it doesn't matter, because we're done with this floor. Phew! Sweet! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! So, sub-level 8. Here we go. I think it's another bonus floor, if I recall correctly. So we'll be able to get our purples up now. Oh yeah! This is gonna be awesome. So, yep, it's a bonus floor. Oh, we can even get our Pikmin numbers up in general. How about we get some yellows? So it turns from red to yellow. So I'm gonna throw it right there. Good. And that's gonna give us the yellows. Sweet. And now... where's the purple ones? I thought there was purple candy pop buds in this place. Maybe it's just the best place to get whites up. You know, whites... colors up, but I thought there was violet candy pop buds. Oh, there is violet candy pop buds around here. Okay. So I'm gonna grab blues. Got lots of blues. So I'm perfectly fine trading those in. Get some nectar set up here for the future with some flowers. Alright, here's some more violets. Okay. I'm not really counting them. I'm just randomly throwing them. I know I can only throw 5 in there at a time. Okay, there we go. Should be good. And, oh, something got sucked in, but that's okay. I guess these floors could be sorta kinda dangerous if you accidentally throw Pikmin off the edge, because that's still a possibility in losing Pikmin and whatnot, but it's not, you know, devastating or anything like that. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can pluck these and get them flowered up. There we go. Not too shabby of a purple Pikmin increase, I must say. And gonna be flower purples too, so that's a big bonus. Actually, some of them are too slow, dang it! But I know there's more nectar around here, so it's not too big of a deal. By the way, you could also trade in colors for other colors if you'd like to, using the Queen Candy Pop Buds, but eh, I don't know, it's just up to you. Maybe I should be separating leaves from the rest of them, just to get this all set up here. Just gonna make sure they're all leaves. Should be like... I mean, there has to be at least 15 leaves that I had so far. And, okay, we got them all. These are all leaves. Through the goo. Good. Alright. And that should be good. yeah, you could breed up some more Pikmin if you need to with the Queen Candy Pop Buds, you know, but my squad is at a full 100, so what else can I do? And I've also got them all flowered, too, so we are good to go. So, final floor is coming up. Get ready for one of the coolest bosses in Pikmin history. I love this thing so much. So much. It's a little bit unfair of its setup, though. Because if you activate it while you have your whole Pikmin squad with you, it's kind of gonna cause losses, probably. So, yeah. First, I would like to show you here. If you zoom out, if you look, it looks like a spider web on the floor. So, you could pretty much guess what kind of enemy we're gonna be facing here. So, you mostly want yellows. But other colors are okay for this as well, but what I'm looking for here before starting this is a wall. Like, this wall will do just fine. And I just want to get them all set up here. I'm going to grab this... Oh no, wait, actually, is that... Do I have any... Okay, I do have whites in here. Got any others? Okay, now I got 16 yellows. I will grab them all with Olimar here, and then put the rest with Louie over here behind the wall, because they are going to need to take cover. And, oops, didn't mean to do that. Poopers, scoopers. I just wanted to... switch over to the other captain. Let's put him in there, and now I'm gonna switch over. There we go. I just wanted them to be holding the C-stick while I push up against the wall like that, so that they're all hugging that like that. Now, get ready. Throw some yellows on here right away! Right away, I say, behold the boss known as Man at Legs! And it's got a laser, which shoots, well, it's more like a scope. And what you want to do is run away from it when it's shooting its bullets. And yeah, as you can tell, I already lost some Pikmin there by mistake. It's okay, it's not that big of a deal. I probably had too big of a Pikmin squad on here anyway. Okay, I'm gonna throw them all up on here while it's shooting, and then it won't be able to shoot any! How do you like that? Oh, it actually... Oh, I forgot about that. It can shoot them because it knocks it off when they're shooting. Ah, poopers. Well, that was my own fault. I forgot that it actually knocks them off when it's shooting. Totally my fault. Oh, and my camera's low on batteries. That's not nice. Well, Well, this isn't good. This isn't good at all. Okay, well, you know what I'm gonna do here? I'm gonna do this, and I'm going to do... Notice that it only attacks you when you attack it. Yeah, it's one of those sorts of enemies here. And I think I'll be able to, God. You know what? I'm gonna restart this floor. Okay, I admit that the flubs I was making in the boss fight was because I was rushing. I got a little worried about the camera being low on batteries and whatnot, so... Yeah, I started going into hyperdrive, and that's not a good idea with this boss. So, let's pretend this is the first time we've been down here, okay? Okay, so when you enter this floor, you might notice that there's a spider web on the ground. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not gonna go through that again. What I mean is that I'm going to think about it as if I wasn't playing under any sort of pressure or anything like that. So, same strategy as before. I'm gonna separate the Pikmin, grab the yellows with Olimar, and yeah, I remember I had 16, and the rest are going with Louie into said corner, like that. Oh shoot, didn't mean to do that. Onto... Get them. No. Oh, shoot. One over on the other side, just like last time and everything. Except it's the white this time, not a blue. Okay, now we switch. There we go. Now, I wonder if I should power them up. Anyway, the strategy with Man at Legs is to attack it, do a little damage, and run away. See, its laser scope rifle thing only shoots at the slowest Pikmin it can shoot at. So, if you continuously move, you will not lose any Pikmin at all whatsoever. And needless to say, I kind of stopped moving at times. I made too many mistakes in the boss battle, so yeah. Now watch what happens if you run around the room properly. Watch us. You can go behind a wall or something to guard, but you're perfectly safe just doing this by running around the room in circles like this. It was actually shooting at the wrong target. It should have been shooting at me, not them. Okay, stop moving, stop moving, stop moving. It's such, it moves so erratically that it's really awkward to throw Pikmin up to. Yeah, you know what, I'm gonna run. Okay, here we go. Now I can demonstrate its movements. Or not. But, huh. It's actually shooting for the other squad for some reason. That's not what I wanted to show. But that's perfectly fine, though. I mean, I don't mind if it does that, because that means it's shooting itself and having no putting itself in a situation where it doesn't really have its own defenses. okay, where's it gonna shoot? Oh, there we go, here we go. Now I can finally show it. See, because it always shoots at the slowest Pikmin, as long as you keep moving, it absolutely can't... Why did it do that? I was gonna say it absolutely cannot kill Pikmin. And, uh-oh, it's doing this again. Hey, come on, this way. This way, man. Why are you hanging around this obstacle? Okay, everyone, let's move. Let's move to a different spot. This is not working in my favor. I don't really mind that it's following me or anything like that. I just don't want it to start shooting while I'm not in a spot that I can run away. Like, right now, I'm perfectly fine and calm and everything like that, because it's not going to be able to kill Pikmin off. I'm just gonna loop around the room like that, and there we go. See? Not really a big deal at all. Maybe what I should do is try and rush it. Get the purple Pikmin and power them up, throw them up on top, and do damage like no one has ever done damage to it before. Run, 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 run. No, it's got a bunch of white there. That's okay. I was just trying something new there. I never tried that before. I didn't know if it would actually work, but I thought it would be something fun. No. I want to throw Pikmin from up here, preferably, because that's the only way that purples can reach him, is if they're at a higher spot. Okay, there we go, there we go. That should take care of it. Yeah, rushing does work to an extent. It's just that I kind of made a big mistake there, but that's okay. We're fine. I win. And this item is really handy for the future dungeons that we're going to come across, especially one known as the Submerged Castle. That mechanized monstrosity is no longer functional. An insect and a machine forming a symbiotic relationship? Life forms here are beyond odd. Initiating area scan. Glass sphere detected. So we want to take back this glass sphere, which is obviously a light bulb. And because it's going to give us something that we're going to notice pretty much immediately once it gets taken back to the ship. Just watch this. See this area? See how the area looks right now? See it? See it? See it? Look how bright it is now. Woo! Stellar orb. If I combine this glass sphere, the synthetic sun I have been secretly developing. Processing complete. I have manufactured a solar system. The artificial sunlight will brighten underground areas. I'm a little disappointed at the loss of all those whites, but I guess I'll take it as is, because I don't think I had any mass losses of purples or anything like that. So I think we are perfectly fine in that regard, and I'm only really worried about the purples. So there we go! Dungeon is now 100% complete! I hope, because for all I know, I might have missed the treasure somewhere. I'm expecting that I didn't, but, well, I guess we shall see! Here we go! If not, I'll be running through here again, but I don't think I missed anything this time. Here we go. Totals! Oh, I feel so bad about the whites, but the whites aren't nearly as important as the purples are anyway, so yeah. 23 lost in the whole cave. It's a dangerous cave, so that's not too bad. Yay! And yes, the cave is indeed complete. And this also means that the day will be, like, pretty much over as soon as we enter. I should say, as soon as we exit this place and enter the Valley of Repose. Because we are on the zeroth second, I guess you could say. The absolute last possible second that we enter the subterranean complex. And, oh, 80% of the depth has been recovered! Woo! And there we go. The day is over! Oh yeah! I'd say that was a pretty successful day. Wouldn't you agree? Maybe? Might be? Well, it is what it is. Even with the loss of whites. Yay! Alright, so there's going to be a couple more treasures that I'll be coming back here for on the next day, as well as one more underground area. So that'll be fun. But for now, let's check our spoils and end off the part. But first, you know, not gonna end off the part before checking the spoils. There's a lot of treasure around this place that I got today. Yeah, that's a lot. Mm-hmm. Oh, had a net loss of 5 Pikmin. That's not too bad. And let's see how the president's doing. Oliver, you'll soon be promoted to manager. Only a small bit of debt remains. You've done great, as have I. What? No one dodges debt collectors like I do. I'm a pro. Alright, and with that, I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you in the next part when we go back to the Valley of Repose.